Hello friends, I am Dr. Neeraj. In today's video, I will show you barbel fly infection in rabbit. So this is dead rabbit got barbel fly infection. So we can easily notice the movement of larva. So these four are larva of barbel fly. We can identify this fly by its size and type of color. So this is a large size fly. And the basic colors including gray, black and white. We can also identify this fly by some other features including its large eyes with light red band in the center, and the top half of face is black with white dot and bottom half is white with black dots. So this is a larva or maggot form of this fly. These larvae are also known as barbel. They found under the skin, usually around the neck and leg, or occasionally around the abdomen. So we can notice these larvae have very fine spine all over the body, indicated by red arrow, and characteristic kidney shape posterior spinae, indicated by a black arrow, and fully grown larvae could be up to 1 to 2 cm. Now life cycle. Port fly doesn't have functional mouth part. It means they cannot bite or feed. So we can say they are non-feeder, seek out rabbits to lay its egg on their skin. Port fly are most active during hot, humid summer months. They can lay several eggs in your pet bunny in just one unsupervised sitting outside. After laying eggs, which develop into nasty larva or maggots, the larvae burrows under the rabbit skin, then feeds on its flesh, which result in large painful cyst with the fistula at the skin surface that become infected by secondary bacterial infection, and it can be fatal. So after infection, the larvae forms a protective purple case around its body called puparium. Then few days later, an adult pod fly emerges from its puparium. So it is the whole life cycle of this pod fly. Now come to the diagnosis part. So diagnosis of pod fly miasis can be done by history and clinical signs. Clinical signs are generally sufficient for a proper diagnosis. So history include presence of pod fly around the environment of rabbit, and clinical sign include presence of inflammatory reaction and visible fistula or cyst in the skin. Or you can also notice viable pod fly larva oozing out from this fistula. We can diagnose this disease by examination of recovered larvae under microscope. So larvae of pod fly have some characteristic feature if we check under microscope. Like if we examine the posterior part of pod fly larvae, so we can find unique kidney shaped posterior spiracles. Number first. Second, posterior spiracle have three slightly curved slits. We can also identify pod fly larvae by its color. The color of larvae mainly black and grays, and the size. Size is typical 1 to 2 cm in length. Now come to prevention. There are number of conditions that will predispose your pet rabbit to suffer such conditions, including flies are attracted to lay their egg under wet condition. So keep your rabbit always dry, especially their perineal area, because perineal area of rabbit always wet because of continuous urination or defecation. So it is usually the target area for fleas oviposition. Other conditions are also predisposed to miasis, like any lesion in skin or continuous ocular discharge. So to avoid these conditions, you should daily examine your rabbit. Timely grooming is necessary and maintain hygienic conditions. Now come to the treatment part. So first of all, physically remove all the larvae as soon as possible with the help of forceps after proper clipping or disinfection of affected part, and avoid crushing or damaging the larvae because the larvae content can produce anaphylactic shock or allergic reaction. So after removing the larvae, the cavity should be cleaned with antiseptic or any insecticide solution. You can use Negasonic powder, and you can prescribe painkiller and anti-allergic medicine after procedure, and routinely dressing is necessary till recovery. Thank you for watching.